Hello all, welcome back to Ma Gurukul. There was a request from Rashmi BG. She is a subscriber of our channel, and her request was how to teach lowercase alphabets, that is writing for alphabets for children. So thank you Rashmi for your request, and this video is dedicated to you, and I hope it will be helpful for all the others who haven't or who are waiting for this video. Okay, so today's video is about how to teach the children to write lowercase. Lowercase means small letters, ABCD. Okay, so before we start writing the lowercase, it is required, or it's very very essential for children to learn pre-writing skills. Okay, so pre-writing skills, or what we call standing line, sleeping line, slanting line. So use a 4-line book, write the date and keep it ready. Right, so the first one is, we teach the child to write the standing line. We start from the red line and stop on the blue line. Okay, standing line, that is start from the red line and start on the red line and stop on the blue line. Okay, so next ones, you just have to draw the dots for them. The child has to join. Okay, so draw the dots, and you can give them as many as you want. Of course, not more than one page. Please don't force the child to write more than a page. So first one is the standing line. Okay, next one is a slanting line. We have two kinds of slanting lines, one which goes from the right hand corner to the left hand corner, and the other one which goes from the left hand corner to the right hand corner. That means slanting line, okay, and slanting line, two different slanting lines. So you can teach both of it to the children. One, okay, again it starts from the blue line and ends on the red line. Okay, so the other slanting line, yes, so standing line and slanting line. Fine, so we have a sleeping line too. So for that, okay, why I am drawing two, so that it's easy for them to understand. This will be on the blue line, or you can give even one also will do. So give the two dotted lines and they will join the dotted lines. Standing line, slanting line, slanting line, sleeping line. And the last one, what we have to teach them is a simple curve, a C curve. Simple C curve. So we just do like this, and then they need to join the C curve. Just two dotted lines, and then they need to join the two dots. Okay, on the blue line. So in between the blue line, you give the dots for them. So this can be done on the opposite side too. So give it to them, and they have to do it on the opposite line too. And remember, never do this. Please don't do this. Now this will be required for capital letters or uppercase. Okay, for lowercase this is not required. So you have to make sure of only the two blue lines. Table shake ho aise na. Okay, there is a reason why we are using only the two blue lines and giving it, because lowercase or small alphabets are pretty small enough, they don't cover the entire 4 lines. Right, so that's the reason. I'm doing it again to you. Standing line, start with the red and stop on the blue. So just put two dots and ask the child to join it.
Okay, the next one is a slanting line, that is from the right hand corner to the left hand corner. The third one is again a slanting line, but which moves upwards. This will be required for W and M. Then sleeping line, we have a curve. Again, for this we just put two dotted lines and then they need to join the curve, and the curve which is facing towards the left hand side. Okay, so these are the basics. Now you can invent as many innovations as possible. You can either just give dotted lines, just give two dots and ask the child to draw these, or you can always create something like this. I'm just giving you one example. Say we have a cloud, okay, and then you put the dots like this. So this is for slanting line, that means it's raining. Okay, then you can again to the same picture, you can again add curves. Once the child is done, ask the child to complete the curve, right? And then slanting line. So okay, that's sun. So you can innovate as many things as possible. Similarly, you can also draw a house. So you can ask the child to, can you check I'm not using the red lines completely, right? So what am I supposed to do? Slanting line, sleeping line. Okay, sleeping line, slanting line. All right. So see as much as possible. Oh, sorry, the dots are wrong. Yes. So as much as possible, then we can give them two more slanting lines. Yes. So you can create as many things as possible and give it to them. Or say, for example, you can just draw this is actually another example. Okay, you can just draw a butterfly. Just draw a butterfly, and the butterfly has to reach the flower. Yes, why will the butterfly reach the flower? To drink the nectar. And how will it has to reach? You have to give it a path. Alright, so you can give a path. The butterfly is gonna reach the flower. Okay, so you can innovate in as many ways as possible. Or if you feel for more such ideas, I think there will be a lot of such ideas or easily printable worksheets for pre-writing skills available. If I do get the link, I will share it in the description below. Okay, so let's not divert from the topic. Once you know that your child is able to do these, even in between the lines, within these four lines, then you know your child is ready. Alright, so once he or she is ready with the pre-writing skills, then we go to the actual writing. Okay, so lowercase, I will show completely A to Z today, but never do that with children. Always try to teach a minimum of only two alphabets. Only two alphabets, a maximum of only two alphabets in a single day. Okay, don't exceed beyond that. So if it is A, right? So it is
video. Please do like, share and subscribe, of course, for all the lowercase alphabets or small letters. And don't forget to pass it on to your friends if you feel it is worth passing on. And do write to me in the comment section if you have any recommendations or if you want any more videos regarding the same. Thank you. Bye bye.